welcome to my channel Mujeeb's Magic. Hope you all are fine. Here I'm going to answer out questions that are related to ICAS. Few were asked by the viewers and some general questions were listed by me. So let's start. These are the list of questions that I'm going to answer. So let's look one by one. So the first question is, do we need to submit both the documents to ICAS for ECA? The answer is yes. We had submitted both bachelor as well as master degree documents for ECA process. Second and third question I'll be clubbing out, that is, what are documents needed for ICAS ECA process and how to send the documents? I'll share one of the slides with you so that you can get clear view about it. Once your online application is completed, you will get an email confirmation that will consist of these three things. Take the printout of document submission form and official record request form and fill it up. These are the forms. Once you have filled both the forms, send official record request form to university by attaching the documents which is mentioned here and then document submission form to ICAS. What happened in our case is, during email confirmation, we had received only one form, that is official record request form. We had filled it up and then sent it to university. Once the university had sent the documents to ICAS, then ICAS had sent another email in which there was document submission form. We had taken out the printout, filled it up by attaching necessary documents which were asked by the ICAS and couriered it to the ICAS address which is mentioned in the official site.
One of the viewers had asked that he has done his distance education from SMU, so which organization to approach? I think this question is asked by many of them in most of the videos. So I'll be sharing out one of the slides, in that you will come to know what all degrees are accepted by ICAS.
Here I have given the comparison between ICAS and WES, wherein the subject I have mentioned degrees and one university, that is SMU. In ICAS, MBA 2-year is awarded as Masters, whereas in WES it is evaluated as 1-year postgraduate diploma. Sikkim Manipal University, which is SMU, is only accepted by ICAS. For MCOM, the evaluation process is same as that of MBA 2 years.
Fifth question is, do we need to submit our original documents? The answer is no. You shouldn't submit your original documents, because once your document reaches ICAS, they will not return it back to you. So just submit your degree certificate copies as well as mark sheet copies, not the original ones. How long does it take place for ICAS ECA process? It will take around 25 to 30 weeks. For us, it had taken almost 30 weeks. Next question is, how much does it cost for ICAS evaluation? For your ECA report, you need to pay $200 Canadian. For other services like courier, they are split into three. If any of your relative is in Canada, you just need to pay $25 Canadian. Or if any of your relative is in USA, you can give their address and there you need to pay $35 Canadian. Or if you want to receive your report in your home country, then you need to pay $85 Canadian. So totally it will be $200 plus the service charges. If you want additional ECA report, then you need to pay $30 Canadian for each report. Whether 1 year MBA will be treated as masters in ICAS? Mostly I don't have any information related to this. According to my perspective, 1 year course after your bachelor degree, that will be considered as 1 year postgraduate diploma. But you can ask about it in ICAS. Can we opt for two different organizations for the same degree? This question looks little bit twisty. Let me explain you with an example. If you have done 2 year MBA and you proceed with this to WES, there they would consider your degree as 1 year postgraduate diploma. This might lower your CRS score. Then you might think what to do. What you can do is, you can approach to other organization where they would award your degree as 2 year masters. this might take a bit longer, so you need to have a clear information before you are opting for any organization for ECA process. And the last question is, what is official record request form? This I have explained in question 2 and 3, you can just look into it. And at last, I like to add on, if your documents are in any other language, that is your native language, that you need to translate it into English or French. Whatever language you translate it, you will get the report into that language. Translate it word by word. If any of your information mismatches, they might reject your document. This was the end of questions. If my video was helpful to you, give a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel to get more updates. Thanks for watching.